Another love song coming up.
Feedback is the key.
That's right, the feedback.
Feedback. Distortion. And lots of screaming. And
don't forget to use the phone.
And yeah, and the phone. The phone is key.
Let's keep in mind that it's just God's way of hurting us.
Thank you.
Thank you, thank you. Okay, that was our sound check. Now let's start playing.
Oh.
rocking. Sirens. Demi song. Has dirty lyrics. You might not want to listen to them. Maybe we just haven't played the right dancing song. I think that's it. Okay, here's a dancing song for all you people who want to dance. Don't you hear me?
had seats. Uh-oh, here we go.
I'd like to thank all my friends. I'd like to thank... Why don't you guys...
Howdy.
We couldn't have done it without Molson's.
Toronto independent music from outside of our borders and creating a focus on Toronto as the center for independent music on an international level.
We
what part does the independent music scene play, do you think, in the overall scheme of the music industry?
The industry is like this, you know, and then there's the independent, you know, like this. It sort of doesn't fit in right now. It seems to me that the only reason there's independence going on is because people just want to do it, so they're doing it. So when you look at the independent bands, you're looking at someone who wants to do what they're doing.
Their way.
Their way, because that's the way they like it.
What do you find to be the biggest frustration about being an independent band in a world controlled by the music biz?
It almost seems in some respects like in the 50s when artists got older and what have you, they crossed over to country music. For example, Conway Twitty, Jerry Lee Lewis. Nowadays, they just keep rolling along, you know, and they're the safe bet. They're the safe bet in the industry because they have a proven track record. And it's just diffused, I think, the whole reason of rock and roll.